Green card lottery winners feel cheated by Trump's visa ban. The administration's latest step to reduce immigration has upended the lives of lottery winners. Noha, an Egyptian engineer, should feel lucky after winning a visa lottery that randomly selects people from a pool of more than 14 million applications for about 55,000 green cards that would let them live permanently in the United States. But the hopes she and her husband had of moving with their two children to New York vanished last week when President Donald Trump extended a ban on many green cards issued outside the United States to the end of the year, including the lottery's diversity visas, which have been issued every year since 1990 to people from underrepresented countries. This year's recipients learned of their good fortune about a year ago, but many had not yet completed the vetting process when American consulates closed in March due to the coronavirus pandemic. Now the administration's latest step to reduce legal immigration has upended their lives, and many find themselves stuck in a worse situation than the one they were trying to escape. Noha, sitting near her home in Cairo, Egypt, the lottery requires that green cards are obtained by September 30 or they will be voided. The State Department says no exceptions are made for those who do not yet have one in hand. Noha and her children got their visas in February. But her husband, Ahmed, is still waiting, and the family fears his visa will never come. The situation forces Noha to make an impossible choice between going alone to New York to seek a better life for the couple's 7-year-old daughter and 9-year-old son, or giving up that dream so the family can stay together. She said she felt angry and cried for days after learning of Trump's order. "All my plans were collapsed in an instant," said Noha, who spoke on the condition that her last name not be used for fear that speaking publicly could hurt her family's case. "I felt that all what we have achieved went for nothing." Trump's decision to extend the ban marked the first time the visa program has been interrupted since it was created to attract immigrants from diverse backgrounds. U.S. immigration lawyers are considering challenging the move in court. Only about 13,000 of the roughly 55,000 lottery visas have been issued so far this year, said Simon Paul, a diversity visa recipient who now runs a blog helping other immigrants at britsimon.com. Even those who obtained a visa have found it tough to get to the U.S. because of pandemic travel restrictions. Noha's family spent nearly $10,000 on the vetting process after being told by a U.S. official in February that the entire family was approved. The couple started making plans for their new life. Noha and her husband, also an engineer, resigned from their jobs, sold their car, notified their landlord they were moving, and stopped paying tuition at their children's school for next year. The embassy in May told her husband his visa just needed to be printed, so we even packed our bags, she said. Her kids watched videos on YouTube about life in the US. The administration put the hold on the visas as part of efforts to free up jobs in the coronavirus-racked economy, a reason the president has used to achieve many of the cuts to legal immigration that eluded him before the pandemic. The president's move also applies to other green card applicants and people seeking temporary work visas at high-tech companies, summer camps, and multinational corporations. Long before the pandemic, Trump criticized the lottery, falsely claiming it has been a horror show because countries put in some very bad people. President Donald Trump arrives on stage to speak at a campaign rally at the Burke Center on Saturday, June 22, 2020, in Tulsa, Oklahoma. And citizens of qualifying countries are the ones who decide to bid for the visas. Foreign governments do not choose who applies or ultimate.